I particularly like structure arrays because they're very good at storing like all kinds of information. So structure arrays are kind of like having a multiple page note card, like we did with multi-dimensional arrays, except that not everything on the note card has to be the same thing. So it's like a cell array with a structure, and it's super, super awesome. And the way that this works is, so say I have, I don't know, a address book. All right. So basically I could say I have my address book, and this is like my super secret creepy file that I have on my friends, and my super secret creepy friend's name, no, they're not creepy, it's just me that's creepy, is Gumbo, and first last name is Puddle Pants. No, that sounds weird. Puddle Pants is not a good name for somebody. How about Ostrich? Okay, so his name is Gumbo Ostrich, because, yeah. Then their salary is $75,000 because I'm that kind of person. And they likes kitties, is true. And this person, I don't know, what else would I do? Their lucky numbers are blah, blah, blah. Whose lucky number is zero? And whatever. Something else important, their car color is maroon. Is that how you spell maroon? I'll pick a word I know how to spell. Magenta, like Blue's friend. All right, so this is a structure array in and of itself. And if I run this, I'll see that I have an address book. There is a value for name that has two things, a salary, likes kitties, lucky numbers, and a car color. So I've got all kinds of different information. It's very exciting. Now I can leave this, and this is perfectly valid. So I have structure arrays, and then I could say, I don't know what it's called, better stuff. Might still be called structure arrays. I don't know. But basically what I could do is, like, what if I'm now like creepily secret friends with more than one person? So I think I'm gonna do this right. So So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have all this information for person number one, all right, so nothing's specifically changed, all right, but now I'm going to have another super secret friend, and my second super secret friend, basically all these are going to become twos, and my next super secret friend, that person's name is going to be Yellow People, and they don't make very much money. So I don't know why I'm friends with them. And they do like it. That's why I'm friends with them. And their lucky numbers are 9, 3, and 2. And their car color is orange. So now you'll see that address book is a 1x2 structure array with fields, name, salary, likes kitties, lucky number, and car color. All right, you seeing this? Smell where I'm stepping? All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna suppress all this stuff just because I can. And now if I just type address book by itself, it's gonna tell me that I got the 1x2 structure array. All right, so I could say, well, tell me who's my first friend, and it'll tell me, or I could say, hey, who's my second friend, and it'll tell me. So let's see if we can come up with something. So find the name of, so the first name of my second friend, find the average salary of my friends, discover if both my friends like kitties, and find the second lucky number of my first friend, stuff like that. All right, so pause the video, see if you can go pull those. Based on your experience with the other stuff that we've done, just give it a whirl and see what could possibly happen. So we'll assume that happened. Okay, now I want to find the first name of my second friend. I'm going to be happy for the moment if I can find the name of my first second friend in general. So, second friend, name. All right, yellow and pickles. So, I think that I want the first one, first name of my second friend. Ah, look, I did it. It was amazing. Okay, I'm kind of a genius. Find the average salary of my friends. So, before I worry about the average, let's say I want all my friends, what is their salary? I'm just gonna see if that works. So let me just put the mean around it, mean of that, and I get 75,000, which is clearly not right, because the two values are 75,000 and the other person makes 15,000. So if I do the mean of those, I should get like something else, but I get 75,000. Maybe because it's not a matrix? Okay, and that seems like a better number. I'll just add them together to be sure. So it's 75,000 plus 15,000 divided by 2. So yeah, they should be getting 45,000. So maybe I just need to put little brackets around that and see what happens. So put little brackets around. I should get 45,000. There we go. That was kind of a lucky guess. Not specifically a genius. That was just luck. All right. Now I want to discover if both of my friends like kittens. Address book. All friends likes kitties. So one and one, they both like kitties. So I want to know. So I'm going to do what I did last time. And I'm going to put those into a matrix. Woohoo! Okay, so now it looks like a matrix. Now I want to know, are all of those equal to one? Do you remember that? All? Yay! Yay! All my friends like kitties. Alright, that was amazing. Now, I want to find my first friend, their lucky number. Did I just call it lucky numbers? And I'm gonna hope that I can just do their second 1 by 2 to get, or sorry, 1 by 2 to get 56. Well, let's see what that looks like. I just book. Okay, so if I go 1 by 2, will I get that? 56! Ooh, I got the answer. I think I got the answer. Yes. Yes, 56. Amazing. Okay. So there you go. We managed to fake our way through that. That was really kind of awesome. All right. So hopefully you're starting to get the idea that you can use different kinds of data types, data structures, and things like that to do all kinds of interesting things, like non-traditional, like you might not necessarily think about doing with MATLAB. But there's all kinds of ways to store information and to access it. And the more experience you get with it, the better you're going to get at it.